To other news now, and keyboard warriors will be held to account under new anti-troll laws proposed by the federal government. Social media companies would be forced to hand over the details of anonymous online abusers or risk being responsible for any defamation costs themselves.
For too long, trolls, bots and bigots have lurked in the shadows online, behind a digital veil of anonymity. Well, not anymore.
Going forward, if they don't tell us who they are, we're coming after them.
Today, the Prime Minister and Attorney General announced new laws to unmask anonymous online trolls, including making big tech accountable for their defamatory actions.
Digital companies, I'm sure, in response to this, in the months ahead and years ahead, will continue to tighten up how they can ensure that they can meet the requirements of these laws.
Anonymous attacks online affect our children, our mental health, and they encourage bad behaviour by others who should know better.
I'm not comfortable that social media companies provide a shield to trolls, and they've turned it in many cases into a coward's palace.
These laws are long overdue. While social media can be a platform for stimulating and robust exchanges, too often it descends into a vile sewer.
We interact in that online world. We deserve to be safe in the online world.
Free speech is not being allowed to cowardly hide in your basement and sledge and slur and harass people anonymously and seek to destroy their lives.
As important as this law reform is, many Australians would like to see the promised Federal Integrity Commission legislated first.
If it wants to stop misinformation on social media, it could start with some of its own members that have been out there spreading misinformation about COVID, about vaccinations and undermining the public health response.
The proposed laws are a world first, but no word yet on when they'll be voted on. Peter Van Onselen for 10 News First.